Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. We've got baseball on the show. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. So, almost ready to get underway, and towing the slab in this one, Shane Baz.
Well, the big thing is that the way he holds his curveball, it's more of a knuckle curve, and because of that, it's less predictable in terms of the break for the hitter. That makes it that much harder to hit this guy.
Ready to go, and stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe. Gets a piece, and stays alive.
Well, they gave up on that pitch early and it ended up staying in the zone. I'm sure he's kicking himself and would like that pitch again.
The 1-2. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, that slider was way out of the zone. And for me, it just comes down to not seeing the pitch out of the hand, not tracking it into the zone, and then also being a little bit anxious, not confident in your two-strike approach. And so when a guy's in that position, you get him to commit early, and a lot of times you get the swing and miss, as you did right there.
Juan Soto now fouled back our way, and that's out of play. One out, base is empty. Down on strikes, and there's two away.
Well, there appears to be no problem settling in on the mound out there today. It looks pretty tough to start this one, punching out the first two hitters of this ball game, and somebody's going to have to put the bat on the ball, put it in play, and get something going.
Here comes Aaron Judge. Slider misses outside. Two down, nobody on. Aye. Three. Got it. Strikes out the side to begin the game. What a start. 1-2-3, go the Yankees. And now the Rays will get their first opportunity in a scoreless ballgame. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Now in Tampa Bay, and towing the slab in this one, Nestor Cortez Jr.
He's a dominant pitcher, but he can get a little too relaxed second and third time through the order and miss his spots. That's where we see him get touched up. If he maintains the same intensity that he has in the first inning and the second inning, I think we'll see him hand the ball over to his closer.
Now it's the shortstop, Jose Caballero. Here's a 1-1. Big swing and miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Grisham on the move, and he hauls it in. All right, let's take a look at the Rays lineup. And now it's Ahmed Rosario. The MO for him is contact, a guy who's going to deliver average, not a ton of power. He's looking to hit a line drive somewhere.
Y'all, that's why it's a team. And when you look at a lineup, he's a great two-hole hitter or a guy that you could put at the bottom to help turn that lineup over to have some momentum for your top hitters coming up to the plate.
In the air, out towards right center. He's got it, and there's two away.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Two outs, base is empty. Isaac Paredes now. Two outs. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And it's a three-up, three-down inning. Down in order, go the Rays. Scoreless after one. all set for the start of the inning. Here's Alex Verdugo.
Number 24, Alex Verdugo.
Hard hit, right side. He takes it on his own. One up, one down.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Gleyber Torres up to the plate. The 1-1 is fouled off. The pitch. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Well, he's really dialed in, and this offense is going to have to do something to try to break that rhythm. Maybe it's square around the bunt, step out of the box, agitate him a little bit, do something that just changes what's happening right now, because at this pace it's going to be a long game, so you got to figure it out quickly.
Two down, nobody on. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Second inning here, no score. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And the Yanks go quietly. Yanks held in check. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Lau at the plate.
And leading up for the Rays, the second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Swings through that.
One ball, two strikes.
Pitch misses there. The count now 2-2. Ed Drummond, our umpire behind the plate in this one.
Yeah, Book, he's a really fair umpire, both the pitchers and the hitters. So standard strike zone, he's consistent with it. And the great thing is you don't see players question the calls too much. So that's a good thing in this day and age.
Got him. And that's the first out.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there. And he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter. But with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Yandy Diaz now. One down, base is empty. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. Stayed inside that ball and squirted up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Now the left fielder, Richie Palacios. And a foul ball. And that one a little bit high.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a pitch. Wouldn't chase that time. Diaz, the base runner at first with one out. And he walked him.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this. But he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. Two on, one out. And a changeup clips the zone for a strike. Fights that one away, still 1-2. The pitch. And another ball.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Runners at first and second with one gone. Bottom half of inning number two. Got him looking for the K.
Just locked him up right there for the second out, and that's an at bat he's probably going to be thinking about for a little while. Didn't pull the trigger. Not how you want to go down in an RBI spot, so now you got to hope your teammate behind you can pick you up.
And now it's Jose Siri. Two on, two outs. That's down and in. A slider missed.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
On the ground, Torres handles in plenty of time to first, and that is the inning. So the Rays strand a pair. We'll move to the third with no score. Now it's LeMahieu up to hit. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. In the air out to center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away. So up next, Austin Wells. One down, base is empty. That's outside. And that's ball two. To the right side. And he takes it himself for the out.
Batting nine. The center fielder, number 12. Trent.
Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. And a swing and a miss.
Wow, that's 89 on the gun, and it's a changeup. It's like good hitting if you're looking for it, but because of the speed differential between the fastball and that pitch, really hard for a hitter to get on time with it.
Left-hand batter waits. A swing and a soft liner. And it gets down, base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Didn't exactly square that one up, but sometimes you don't have to. There are a lot of nicknames people have attached to hits like that. Blooper, Flare, Duck Snort, Lawn Dart, etc. But whatever you want to call it, it's a knock. And those are the ones that will make you smile as a hitter just about every time.
Swing and a miss as he was late that time. Two. The shortstop takes the ball. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. One hit, one left. We head down to the home half of inning number three. We're tied. Nothing, nothing. Now the catcher comes up to him, Ben Wortvedt. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. A line to kick the pitch. And now the count is even.
Yeah, and because he's got the big arm, he pays attention to the running game and is sure to manage it.
And a swing and a miss. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got the changeup and still wait on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, there's no way you're going to touch a fastball.
So the lineup flips over. Here's the Rays' leadoff hitter, Jose Caballero. Swing and a miss. And it's one and two.
When you have a catcher that can throw like that, a pitcher doesn't have to worry as much about the slide step. He can keep his mechanics intact and have a better opportunity of getting that hitter out with a swing and miss.
And a pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Still tied at zero, last of the third. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
They had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Ahmed Rosario, next to hit for the Rays. And now two balls and a strike. Well, Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. That misses. And now 3-1. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep, because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. In the air, left field, down the line, Verdugo going back on this one. Couldn't get to it before it dropped foul. And now the lefty. Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field, and that'll fall for a base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder. Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
Drifts towards it. And that will end the inning. The Rays strand just the one, and we're still knotted at zero. Juan Soto stepping in now for the Yankees.
The right fielder, Juan Soto.
And it is 2-1.
You know, these Yankees, to put it bluntly, need to put together more competitive at-bats, and I don't think they've lived up to their own expectations at the plate. Strikeouts are a little easier to stomach in baseball today, but even by those standards, they're going down way too often, and I think they're having a hard time getting any momentum going as a result.
Pitches in the dirt, full count 3-2.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Got him looking, and he did not like the call.
Quite the start to this game on the mound, looking very dangerous to these hitters. 7 punchouts already, so this lineup hasn't had much success trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
Down, base is empty. That's inside.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
And that's a base hit.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Nice job going the opposite way with it, letting the ball travel and not allowing the barrel to hook around the ball. It's so frustrating when you see a good pitch and your hands roll over. It was on the outside part of the plate, and he approached it perfectly.
And now here is Alex Verdugo. Righty delivers. Out towards right center field. Siri sizing this one up. And it's threw away.
Now back. Second baseman.
Gleyber Torres up to hit. Fourth inning underway. No score. Next offering is fouled back. Caballero. The throw to first. And Gleyber Torres retired. Third out. The Yanks leave one. And we are still scoreless. And now it's Brandon Lau.
For the Reds, the second baseman, Brandon Lau.
And a 1-1.
That's ball two. Two balls, one strike.
Swing and a ground ball out to short. And one he's gone out to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And stepping in for the Rays, Yandy Diaz. All tied up. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Line of the pitch. And there's a ball. That one ripped. He's got it. And there's two away.
Now got left fielder, Ricky Palacios.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Richie Palacios. Two outs, base is empty. The 1-1 is fouled off. That misses the zone, and the count is 2-2.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
And that one missing low.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Two outs. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Ground ball up the middle. On the run, sends it over to first. Rays retired in order. Nothing doing for Tampa. Still no score. And now the first baseman.
The first baseman, Ben Ryan.
And a 2-1 on the way. And a good eye there.
You know, these Yankees doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They haven't produced a run yet, but the pitch count for the starter is starting to climb. So they're...
This one's into the outfield. Could be extra bases. Safe at second with a leadoff double.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
one on base. Now at the plate, DJ LeMahieu. Battling here as he fouls it away.
And I think they're in a good spot thanks to their pitching, but no one would be shocked if this offense strings something together to take the lead.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens?
Just missed. The Yanks looking to strike first, and we're at the top of the fifth. Swings and misses, and the build up.
That he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
And ball four to a board. First and second, one out. Stepping in, Trent Grisham.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
And that's a little bit high. 2-1.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
And that one clips the corner. Tampa Bay's bullpen with some action. Edwin Uceta, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Two on, one out. On the ground, right side. Dives, but it's off his glove. The throw is still in time, and they get it out of the play.
This is what it's all about on that right side of the diamond when you've got the first baseman involved and the pitcher as well. First baseman does a great job, knocks the ball down, gets away from a little bit, doesn't panic. The pitcher's exactly where he's supposed to be. Nice feed and a nice play for the out.
And down to shortstop, Anthony Volpe. That one missed.
Yeah, two balls, one strike.
Two outs, two in scoring position. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. And the righty deals. In the air, left field. Base hit, one run is in. Here's the throw to the plate. He's in there. And they take a two-run lead. The right field. One. Two outs, runner on first. And now it's Juan Soto. And here it comes. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Ripped on the ground a second. Over to first. They get the out on Soto. That's out number three. They put two on the board with a couple of hits, no errors, and one left. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Yankees 2, the Rays nothing. Randy Arozarena digs in now.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
Comes up empty. That's strike two.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
And that's downstairs and outside.
Two balls, two strikes.
The 2-2. And that one lifted in the air center field. Grisham settles under it. Makes the grab. And there's one down.
Up next in Tampa Bay, the center fielder,
Jose Siri, next to hit for the Rays. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful.
And I would say that most great defensive outfielders, it's kind of natural. There is some work that you can do to it to improve your game, but ultimately, you either have it or you don't.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. He circles the bases. It's 2-1.
That was one of those home runs where you really don't know if he got enough of it off the bat. Swing on it clearly, but I wouldn't say he really got the sweet spot on the bat. The exit velo wasn't anything too impressive, but it had all it needed for him to circle the pillows.
Now a chance for Ben Wortvedt. One down, base is empty. That one fouled off, 2-2. The wind and the pitch. Come on and miss. Struck him out. Two gone now.
And a left-handed batter facing a left-handed pitcher that's got some sink like that at the end. It's just the bottom falls out of it. But it looks like it's going to be a pretty good pitch in that location that everyone says lefties love.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Jose Caballero. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Grisham moving under it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. The Rays creep closer thanks to the homer. And this is now a 2-1 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. New arm out of the bullpen, Kevin Kelly.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Kevin Kelly.
Here is Aaron Judge. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Here comes a pitch. Judge rips that one. Judge out of the play. And a quick out, number one.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. Looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
One down, base is empty. Fouls one off, 2-2. Righty to the plate. High in the air, out to right. The Rosarena after it. Two away.
Now back. The second baseman. Gleyber.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the second baseman, Gleyber Torres. Two down, nobody on. And we're the top half of the sixth. Up the middle. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. That leaves him without a throw, and they don't get an out on the play.
Up next, the first baseman, Dan Wright.
And here's the first baseman. That one drilled left field. And in one hops the wall. Lead runner gets the stop sign at third. It's a two-out double, second and third now.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Up to the plate steps DJ LeMahieu. In the air, right field. The Rosarena moving under it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Yanks strand a pair as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Well, one run game. Now it's the DH, Ahmed Rosario. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Movement in the bullpen. Phil Bickford getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Ferguson, a left-hander, also throwing. And there's a ball.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
Wouldn't chase that time. Isaac Paredes up next for the Rays. The pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Pulled the string of the changeup.
Now, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base pass, it's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
The Rays trailing by a run here in the bottom of the sixth. And now it's filled up.
We got a full count.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Here comes a 3-2. Popped in the air, left field, and it falls. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely. And that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Nestor Cortes Jr. out of the game. He exits with the lead and gave them a really nice performance. New pitcher on the bump when we get back. The left-hander on now, Caleb Ferguson.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
Man at first with one gone, Brandon Lau. Next to hit for the Rays. Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Paredes, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss, struck him out. He swung over top of the curveball.
Well, oftentimes that's the pitch he's trying to set off. The curveball, he'll lean on it pretty heavily, so you got to be expecting it. Look for it and sell out so you don't miss it when you get it.
And now the first baseman, Yandy Diaz. And a foul ball. The pitch.
That's ball two.
Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Paredes around second, headed for third. Coming home. He'll score, and the Rays tie the game. It's 2-2.
Well, we're starting over again, all tied up. When you connect and he jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. What a great swing on him, man. He wasn't fooled at all. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
So two down, and stepping in for the Rays, Richie Palacios. And it's second. Waves at the bender for the strikeout.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
Now a new pitcher for the Rays, Garrett Clevenger. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Here's the catcher, Austin Wells.
They're surprised. They don't see a pinch hitter here, but the lefty-lefty matchup. Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
And they get the leadoff hitter in the second.
That's that classic wipeout slider below the zone right there. Just nasty. Looks like a fastball thigh high that you got to protect the zone, and then it's just that late break that fools you and kind of makes you look silly.
Trent Grisham getting ready to hit. And he's swinging and a miss there.
One ball, two strikes.
And that's in the dirt. Bullpen movement for the Rays. Phil Maton warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Armstrong getting loose as well. One down, base is empty. Slider misses outside. The other way, and it goes just foul. And he deals. Hit in the air, center field. Siri in position. And it's caught for the out.
The bat, number 11.
Back to the top of the Yankee order. Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. All tied up here in the top half of inning number 7. Next that's offering is downstairs. Hopped up. Under it. Brings it in for the third out. So the Yanks go in order. Score remains 2-2. New pitcher for the Yankees, Phil Bickford.
Number 53, Phil Bickford.
Randy Arozarena now at the plate.
The right fielder, Randy Arozarena.
The 1-1. That one out to right. Soto going after it. Corrals it. And there's one down.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the center fielder,
Jose Siri will hit next. Base is empty, one away. Here the bottom of the 7th. Swing and a ball popped up. Torres in position. And there are two down.
That was a good hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop up and an easy out for the defense.
Two down, nobody on. In there for a strike at the top of the zone. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Two outs. On the ground to the left, Volpe. Fires over to first. Play made, that ends the inning. Rays held in check here. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Here's Juan Soto.
The right fielder, Juan Soto.
And another ball. Just missed. Aaron Judge up next. The wind of the pitch. Fly ball to right. Rosarena moving under it. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
One down, base is empty. Pitch misses. Ball two. Kicks and fires. That's the third. Paredes. Judge out on the play.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got now the ground ball.
The left hander,
Alex Verdugo stepping in now for the Yankees. Two down, nobody on. And we're at the top of the eighth. That one missing inside.
Boom, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Two down, nobody on. Lined, and that's a base hit.
All over that one right there. Just an awesome swing of the bat, quick hands, and just launched the baseball. 108 on the exit velocity. Man, that is coming off the bat pretty good. I know he's feeling good about it.
And the Rays, they go to the bullpen. Sean Armstrong.
Armstrong.
Two outs, runner at first. Here comes Gleyber Torres.
One, two, three,
that one not close, and it's 2-2.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Right-handed reliever. Wouldn't chase that time.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Got it! And that is that. One left for the Yankees. And this game is still tied at 2-2. Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Jose Caballero.
This guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Next offering is down low.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
That one missed.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
Ahmed Rosario, next to bat for Tampa. kicks and deals. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
Now that's a really dangerous base runner to put on first, especially the tie game. Now there might be some consequences coming from that mistake.
At the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Ahmed Rosario. And a count 1-2.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Next offering upstairs.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
Two, two now. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Isaac Pareda. Glover takes off, pitch in for a strike, and it's safe. It's a stolen base. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
Man at second. And a swing and a miss. And now two gone.
Big strikeout there as he works to strand that go-ahead run at second base. But job's not done yet. Got to get that last out before you can exhale and get back into the dugout. It's kind of tough to do with this home crowd applying so much pressure.
Jim Hill taking over on the mound.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with a lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Brandon Lau. Good eye right there.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Two outs. Late swing, foul to the left. Swing and a miss. The hat trick. That's the inning. One left for Tampa. It's the ninth, and we are tied. And here's the first baseman.
The first baseman. Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
That's outside low. Now 3-1. DJ LeMahieu. Waiting to hit for the Yankees. At the belt and fires. And he grounds one back up the middle. Sneaks through, base hit. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there's just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
No outs, runner at first. And now it's going to be in a sack bunt here. Diaz. They put the tag on him, and he gets the job done. So digging in, Austin Wells.
Well, first base open. Really no reason to pitch to this hitter right here. Put him on, have the force at second, first, perhaps getting any ending double play.
One, two now.
Nope, outside.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Right-hander kicks, deals. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Man at second. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Nice work there to get the strikeout, and that's a big second out. I'll tell you, this home crowd will be fired up. They can get out of this and leave that go-ahead run stranded in scoring position. This is a big moment in this game.
And now the center fielder, Trent Grisham. That's ripped into the outfield. No one can get there. It falls in. The run scores from second. It's 3-2. And that's a double.
Big RBI for him right there. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
And up next for New York, Anthony Volpe. Man on second, two down.
Yeah.
Strike two. And a pitch. Outside low, 2-2. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Down the line. And that will drop foul. Two outs. Fights it off. You'll see another. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. This to center field. Siri in position. And makes the grab. And that is that. Yankees strike for a run on the RBI double. And the home team down a run. Major League Baseball is on the show. New pitcher on here, Clay Holmes.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And stepping in for the Rays, Yandy Diaz. What are you looking to do in these spots? You're down a run. You're leading off the inning.
He's not a power hitter, a guy that's looking to tie it up with one swing. So he's going to take and get into this at bat and try to get deep into the bat. Ultimately, however he can, get to first base.
Drops into the glove, and there's one down.
As good as he's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand, you cannot hang a breaking ball right there. Lucky it stayed in the ballpark.
He's two outs away. Richie Palacios next to hit for the Rays. Looking to get the tying run on base. That one to first. And he handles it himself for the out.
That's why you hug the lines on the corners late in a ball game like this. Positioned perfectly.
So they're making a move for a bat off the bench. Josh Lowe, a critical at bat in this game for him. A one-run lead as the Rays try and punch back down a run. And another ball.
Well, an interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
A 2-1. Wow, nice play. The throw. And that's the ball game. What a play to finish it.
What an exciting finish to this game. An amazing play right right there. It's hard for the fans to go home. They want more. They're not ready to leave and head to their cars, but an outstanding job to keep entertaining all the way to the end.
A 3-2 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shombi. We'll see you soon.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, three runs on nine hits, no errors, they left seven runners on base.